I had to take the autofocus off and let me allow links. Okay, links are allowed. Okay, hi everybody. Today is Fun Day Monday and it's April. Oh my gosh, it's August the 15th. April. Yeah, we get with the program. So it's August the 15th and you're watching Create with Ella and I'm Ella. And we have a live audience that we chat with. If you're watching this on the recording, unfortunately, you won't be able to see the chat or participate in the chat. But trust me, we have a good time. And hopefully, someday you'll be able to join us for the live show, which is at 7:30 Eastern Time every Monday. So, yeah, I know, April. Where did I get that from? Oh, mercy. So, the last time I talked to you guys, I showed you some happy mail for my birthday, and then I was going to show you some last Monday, but I had a doctor's appointment, and I couldn't stream, and we'll talk about the doctor's appointment in just a minute, but I wanted to show you two really pretty birthday cards I got, so after, you know, the first batch I showed you. So this one is from Burn Pink. Her real name is Mildred, but it's Burn Pink in the chat. And it says, Dear Ella, hope you have a wonderful birthday and many more. So it says, why did the cracked bird cross the road? And here's the road and here's the cracked bird. And then you pull us out and says, to wish a friend a happy funky birthday. So I thought that was really cool. I just really like that. I thought that was really nice. And so she signed it on the back. So thank you so much. I love it. And then this one is from my friend Bunny. I'm not sure if Bunny's here. Let's see if Bunny's in here. No, Bunny hasn't made it in here yet. But Bunny made me this one. She knows I love birds and bird cages. And this wreath, I thought this was really pretty. And she says, Ella, celebrate you today. Happy birthday. Hugs, Bunny. And then she put her initials on the back. So thank both of you, Mildred, a.k.a. Burn Pink, and Bunny. Bunny is Bunny BMC, I believe. So thank you both for both of those and the other cards that I got as well. So, you know, I said I couldn't stream last week because I had a doctor's appointment because I had another blister on my gum. So I went in and I saw my dentist and he took care of it and drained it and everything. And so far, so good. It's not come back. But I need implants on my lower gum line. But he said, I'm not going to do any of that until you're completely over whatever infection is in your body causing you to get all these abscess teeth, because your teeth aren't causing it. So I have an appointment next week with the gastroenterologist about the biopsies, and I don't know, I just hope she can tell me where this infection's coming from. I don't know. And then 2 weeks after that, I have an appointment, my annual appointment with my endocrinologist. And I go to the endocrinologist just because, you know, I'm not a diabetic. I don't have any endocrinology problems. But I started going to her when nobody else could give me any answers as to why I was so tired and felt run down and like a Mack truck had run over me several times. And she was the only one that would even consider helping me with medication. And she said, well, you know, I know, Terry, I agree. She said, you are borderline anemic, so I'm going to give you a very small dose of Synthroid to jumpstart your thyroid. And I'm going to put you on iron. And in 2 days, I felt like a new woman. So I go see her every 6 months. She does a complete blood panel on me. And, you know, we regulate or whatever we need to do. So, I don't know. But I told my dentist, I cannot go through another abscess tooth like the one I had in June. I said, I just can't go through that again. So we need to find out what the heyday is going on. So we'll see. He laughs at me. He thinks it's kind of funny. He's frustrated too, you know, because I need this dental work. I need the implants and I can't get them because if I get them and I keep getting these infections, it could get worse or my body could resist them. And then you know how that could be. But anyway, enough of that stuff. We could sit here all day and talk about our aches and pains. Okay, so today I'm going to work in my Strathmore Mixed Media Journal. I found out about this journal from Cass 1415, a.k.a. Kathy Arbor. It's for mixed medium, it's vellum finish, acid-free, and you can use it for wet or dry, and that's what I love about it. It's 140 pounds. So, you know, I'm going to keep this part on here until I finish the journal, and then I'm going to put something on the front. It has this really nice finished front. But this is my tea journal. I love tea. I do love tea. Let me zoom out a little bit. I love hot tea and iced tea, even though I hardly ever drink iced tea anymore. That's another story. But I do enjoy hot tea in the evening sometime, especially here. Around starting in October, November, I like to have a cup of hot tea. Right now, it's too warm at night to have hot tea. So, hi, Zandra. I focus on water right now. Water, 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 water. But I love teacups. I love tea parties. I love teapots. And I love the whole thing. So this is the introduction to my journal. So today we're going to work on this part. So I somewhat have an idea of what I want to do. I'm not 100% sure how it's going to turn out. I know, Zandra. I know you've been really sick. But you know what? If it's a hot mess, we have 20 some odd more pages in this journal, and we'll just keep on trucking. So this is a picture of some teacups that I cut out of a magazine. There were four teacups. I don't know. Oh, here's the other two. They were stacked like this, right? And I just cut them apart to look like that. So I have an idea. We're just going to see what happens. I don't know. So this is the new silicone brush by Prima. It's the Art Basics Prima brush that was, it's part of Finnebar's line. This is the 2-inch and I have the 1-inch. And I got them to put for putting gesso on the page. I read a lot of good reviews about them from people that have used brushes and this, and I think the main reason I'm going to like this one is the brushes. Yeah, I know, Jen. I love the page you put up this morning, Jen. I just thought that was too cool, and I like the one before that too. I don't think I paid $10 for these, Terry. I got them from A Cherry on Top, which I have to tell you a funny story about that. I ordered them from A Cherry on Top with some paper, right? When I went to check out, it said they couldn't send me these brushes because I live in the great county of Ventura County. Now, the history behind that, I knew exactly what they were talking about because I tried to order some liquid pearls off Amazon. And they would not send them to me because I live in Ventura County in California. Well, my husband told me that one of his co-workers had the same problem. He went to order something from Amazon. They wouldn't send it to his house in Ventura County, but they would send it to his friend's house in Bakersfield, and his friend could mail it from Bakersfield to where I live. So, go figure. Well, anyway, I ordered these two brushes from A Cherry on Top, and it said, we can't, you know, we're unable to send you those brushes in big red letters. So I was like, okay, fine. I'll get my lady at the local scrapbook store to order them for me. So, you know, my box comes. I'm excited to see my paper opening up. And guess what's sitting in there? These two brushes. Can you believe that? So they must have found out that they could send them to me after all. Because, Jen, in California, we have the craziest emission and environmental regulations. I mean, not 2 miles down the road from me, they cleared this land, built this beautiful, they were going to put a housing community in there. And you know where it is, Terry, if you come over this side. It's on Harbor and Fifth, right down by Oxnard Shores. So they did this beautiful wall, and they graded it and everything. It was gorgeous. And right before they got ready to put the stakes in to mark for the houses, they found some, that's what I'm going to tell you, that's what I'm telling you about. They found some kind of, you know, little bug about this big that's supposed to be, you know, in danger, and they stopped the whole project. So that's how crazy our rules are here. So there's something in this silicone. I don't know what it is. There, I have no idea, but they weren't going to send me these, but they managed to be able to send me these. But I cannot get liquid pearls. I can have them sent to another county in California, but not to my house here in Ventura. I don't know. It's crazy. Endangered mites. Yeah, go figure. So I have not gessoed my page. So I'm going to do that. But I think the real reason I'm going to love this brush is because there's no brush marks. And I know that you can put the paint, the gesso on, and then use a card and go over it. And, you know, you won't have the brush marks. But I get frustrated when the brush mark, when the brush hairs come out, and then I got to dig it out my paper. I get frustrated about that. So anyway, yeah, $9 on the cherry. But you know what? To me, it's well worth it. So if it's not Terry, I'll send it to you. And then you, ooh, too much gesso. And then you can say that you, then you can say you have one. So let me put some of this back in here. Come on, baby. Sorry if I'm bursting y'all's ears. Okay, and so it goes on real easy. You know, gesso's our best friend, as Jen says. I love that page. You guys got to go watch the page Jen put up today. If you think, oh, I was going to put a piece of paper in here so I could not have to worry about my paint and stuff. Go watch the page that Jen just put up. If you think you can't make something pretty out of what you don't. So you're starting a page and you don't like it and you think, oh, you know, I'll never, this is a waste. I'm just going to rip the page out. Go watch Jen's page. She did a great job. She was doing her page and she used a stencil and she didn't like it. And, you know, she was like, oh no, I don't like this. And she redid it a couple times and it turned out gorgeous. Just gorgeous. So let me just get this down. Yeah, see, Terry, I'm telling you, it was worth it. It makes life so much easier, I think. But, you know, we each have our limits as to how much we'll spend for things, right? So, we have to work within those limits. Some people think, you know, $9 is a lot for a brush. Some people like me that's going to be using that brush all along. No, Jen. Oh, what happened to my... We had a power outage here the other night. I don't know if you had that, Terry. Probably not. And now my... See if this is working. Oh, heat gun. Sorry. Sandra has them and she likes them too. See? They're nice. Yeah, the cleanup's easy. I just, you know, if I tend to leave my brushes in water, except for my phenobar brushes, and sometimes I leave them in water too long, which, you know, hasn't damaged them, but I don't want to have to worry about I got to clean up my brushes immediately after doing something. No, it's not removable. No, it's not removable. It's, you know, it's put inside this, and then this black is crimped around it, and it has two screws right there, and this part is a little wider than this, so it's not going to come out. Yeah, that's what I'm using it for, is a glue brush. Exactly. All right, so just a second. I think so too, Jen. I think so too. Okay, so now what I want to do, and like I said, I don't know. We'll see how it's going to turn out. But these other two I've chosen. This one's kind of pinkish and then blue here and a little green here and a little pink in there. So I'm going to use these paints. These paints I got when, well, I bought this one. And these I got when I took classes at, no, this I got when I took a class at CHA. And this I bought. Okay. So... Ow. What you piping down about? Is the metal, is the black metal? Here, let me open this other one because that one's in water. Yes, the bat, this is metal. I think, I guess. Maybe it's plastic. I don't know. I didn't think about it. I just liked it and I bought it. Hi, messy blogger. I wouldn't think it would rust, and I'm gonna tell you why. Phenobar uses a lot of paint, all right, and mediums. And if this was gonna rust, I don't think she would put her name behind that. So, Zandra can chip in and say, because she's familiar with Phenobar's work too, but I don't think Phenobar would put her name on something that's going to rust. So, I think it's a heavy-duty plastic. I don't think it's metal. Hear that noise? She uses much more than all of us together, right? So anyway, what I'm going to do is I have another piece of wax paper here I'm just going to use as a little palette. And I'm just going to take these three colors and put them on my page. But I mean, don't buy it just because I like it. If you don't think you should will like it, then I wouldn't buy it. And I say that because that's how I roll. I don't buy it just because someone else likes it or they say, you know your style better than I do. And if you don't think it would work for your style, then you know. So I'm just going to take this sponge and I'm just going to go all around the page. Now, I'm telling you, I have no idea what this is going to turn out to be. I say if you think it's something you'll like, you know, then go for it. Oh, you're buying it because now you're seeing it in action. Okay, because you know where I live. I don't want you coming to my house and you know, you made me spend $9.09 on a brush, and it's a piece of you know what. Which would be funny if you came over here and told me that. Okay, so now I'm gonna put some. That color was Apple Barrel China Blue. Apple Barrel China Blue. Okay, this color is Paper Artsy Granny Smith Opaque. Paper Artsy Granny Smith Opaque. So I am tapping it off on the wax paper over here. Terry doesn't live that far from me, you know? So I don't want her coming over here and saying to me, I bought this because you said didn't lie, now it's that lie. Even though we probably would have a good laugh over it. So I'm just using my sponge and putting color all over the page. And I do want to leave a little bit of white in there. Okay, and now this color is Folk Art Sahara Gold. Folk Art Sahara Gold. Okay. And the green was Paper Artsy Granny Smith. And the blue was Apple Barrel China Blue. Come on, there you go. Okay, so now we're going to try some of the gold. And I always dab off onto a palette or something so I don't get a big glob of paint. And yes, Terry, that door noise you hear is the wind that you teased me about last week. I mean, last time I streamed. Yes, she does, Zandra. She lives about, I don't know, what do you think, Terry? 20 minutes? She lives on the east side. I live on the west side. I live near the ocean where she wishes she could live sometimes because of the heat. Okay, I think that's pretty. You borrowed what? Oh, way less than 20 minutes? Yeah, probably, huh? Okay, so I'm just going to fold this over and leave that there just in case I want to use it again. So now, maybe 15? Yeah, probably, huh? So now I'm going to dry this. So, heat gun. Poor me, I know! I'm going to call her and I'm going to say, Terry, put your clothes on. I want to come over. And she's going to laugh at me. Well, you could wear something as long as it was clothes. Hey, Bunny, I showed your card. Everybody liked it. Is Mildred here? Is Burn Pink here? Okay, so I think that's good. So now what I want to do is I want to put this like here. And this is a Anna Griffin stencil called Secret Garden. Let me take autofocus off. Yes, jammies are fine. This is Secret Garden by Anna Griffin. And she has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 others. And I don't remember where, I got this at Hobby Lobby, $7.99. So what I was thinking I could do is I could put this part here, up here, then clean it and flip it and put a piece here. And I have this little quote I want to write there. Or I could just put that piece there and this piece down here. I don't know. And then I'm going to take my Zig Clean markers and color those in. So wish me luck. So I'm using, I'm using, this is another thing I got at a class I took at, Prima Art Venture with Finnebar. Oh, it's 114 in Palm Springs. Oh. I know I'm late. Is that a pic she printed? No, my dear. I cut that out of a magazine. Cindy. Okay, so it came like this. And I cut it apart. And I'll use this part somewhere else. This part I'm using today. Okay, so let me get my, got my stencil, I got my gesso, I mean my paste. Be careful, that one little piece there. Okay, hopefully I didn't mess it up too much. Oh no, that'd be very pretty. And then I think I'm gonna I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna put it there. Because I want to put this one down in the corner. So that can sit right there on that paper. So I'm not looking at the chat right now, guys. I'll be back to the chat in just a second. Okay, so put this aside. Put that in some water when all said and done. And then let me see if I can get some of this back in this tube. Okay, that's good. Okay. Oh, Cindy. She did. She struggled, bless her heart, for 2 years, and she's no longer struggling anymore. Yes, and she got to see her dad, who's doing really, really well. I think, you know, we were talking about this the other day, Cindy and I, and her dad has done his grieving for the past 2 years. He saw her go downhill really fast and struggle and knowing there was nothing could be done for her. And so he did his grieving, and yes, he misses her and everything, but he no longer has to see her in the hospital and suffering and being poked and prodded. So our prayer was that Cindy would get here, and she did. Got here that Wednesday, and you know, it was a blessing because we got to be together and pray with her mother and love on her, and all was good. Yes, her father, right, Cindy, her dad is so calm, and it's just you know, it's wonderful in a good, and you know, like we said, he misses Donna, but he knows that, oh yeah, the bird. Yeah. I just want to dry this a little bit more because it's got to be really dry before I can color. Hi, Jean. No problem. How is your mom? Correct, Terry. That's right. Very much so. Oh, I think that would be so pretty. I don't know if they're dry enough. Maybe I can do some stamping. I have these. I have these Ladybird collection cling stamps from Prima. And these little butterflies are really sweet. This little bird. Let me get some ink and some blocks. Just a second. haven't gone anywhere, guys. I'm looking for some ink. Okay, well, I picked several colors and we'll see which one we like the best. Oh, good, Jean. Okay, thanks, Terry. So, we're going to do the block. Oh, there's the block. So, we have these cute little butterflies. Let me see if I like that. See, I have this quote I want to put right here. I should put them down like this. And then I have this cute little bird. Isn't he cute? Maybe we can put him there. Oh my God, Bunny, that's funny. Okay, so I'm just going to stamp some butterflies up in here, and I think that's going to be too blue, so I'm going to use Stays On Spice Chai, I hope I like it. Let's see. I think you can see it. Can you? Can y'all see it as well as I can see it? Oh, that was funny, Jean, when you did that with the chin. But you did it well. I want to put some butterflies. I'll wait and paint that first. Okay, and then the baby one, just a little baby one here. And then I might add some more in just a second, but I want to get this down first. So, I'm going to use my gloss gel medium. So I need some more. Okay. I think I need some more over here, up here. So let's see, I think I have it like this. Just a second. I want to get this little crease out right here. Now, if you do use a brush and not like I just did, and you don't want the brush marks, I noticed Jen does this on her pages. She uses the brush to, you know, put everything down. Then she takes one of these cards and she smooths it over and you don't see the brush marks. So if other people do that, I'm happy. I'm not trying to say anything except I saw Jen do it and I thought it was a great technique. So, that's still not dry enough to paint over. So, okay, my dear, I love you too. Thanks for dropping by. You want to be careful when you're heating up your paste because it can bubble on you. So you don't want it to, you don't want to get your brush too close because it will bubble on you. Yes, links are open. It came through, Jean. Thanks. So, let me see how this is going to do. I'm going to get out my Zig Clean. My Zig Clean markers and see how it's going to do. And if I think it's going to ruin my marker, then I won't use it. Okay, I think this pink one will be good. Let me see. Hi, CB. Let's try this one. So let me bring it in so you can see what I'm doing. So I'm going to color this rose and this flower here, and I'm using the Zig Clean markers, which I love. They are watercolor marker, and they have a brush tip. I made sure my paste was very dry because I don't want them to ruin my brush. Terry, your house really holds the heat, huh? Well, she probably don't get hardly any wind out there. And I think this is a flower too. So let me see what color green this is. That pink was sugar almond pink, and this green is mid green. Just trying to figure out if this is another flower or is this yeah, you probably don't get hardly any wind out there, Terry. Whereas I get the ocean breeze and sometimes it's downright cold. Okay. I'm gonna put a little dab of this pink on there, and this is just pink, 025. And then I want to see if I blend that out some with the go back with the lighter pink and blend that out. I'm pulling the color towards the center so that it blends in. So I put my lighter color down first, and then I put some of the darker color in. Then I went back with the lighter color, and I'm blending towards away from the darker color. See, I'm pulling the ink away from the darker color. You don't have such a harsh line. And you decide where you want to put the color, and then you just move it around. Pretty simple. You think Rio's been a disaster? I've enjoyed what the parts I've watched, the swimming and the gymnastics, the diving. I don't like that color there. Yeah, I understand what you're saying, Jen. Maybe I'll do a very light purple right here. I bought a case for these, and it came, and I put them in the case, and it wasn't what I wanted it to be. So I took them out and I'm going to get some other kind of case. Because I don't want anything that's going to sit on my desk. Because I don't have, if I put all my pens out on my desk, I wouldn't have no room for nothing else. The reason I don't want to rubber band them is because that system just doesn't work for me. I had them like that to begin with. And this case that I'm pulling them out of, and it just drove me nuts. I pull one out and the rubber band would come off or something would come off. And so I'll figure it out. I think I know what I'm going to do. I just need to do it. The reason I'm putting lavender down here, light violet, is because this teacup right here that you can't see has lavender in it. Yes, yeah, I get that, Jen. I do. Okay, so I think we got that one all dry. I mean, all painted. Okay, take us into your kitchen. So I'm gonna let that dry and I'm gonna turn the book this way and I'm gonna work on this flower. Me zoom in some, I mean, out some. I'm gonna work on this flower right here. And these flowers, guess I could make them blue. Let's see if I have a lighter blue. Oh, yeah, let's see what this one looks like. I think that's too light. Okay. We're going to go with this one. This is called Light Blue, number 036. Again, these are Zig Clean Color. real brush markers, and I put some texture, used a stencil and put some texture paste down, and I made sure the paste was completely dry before I used my markers because I didn't want it to ruin my markers. So if you have a question for me or you want to say something to me, if you'll type in all caps, that helps me a lot because when I look up, I'll see it right away. Oops, that piece wasn't dry right there. Just give it a little texture. I'm moving the book around so I can get to the... Okay, I'm still on screen. Okay. And I'm using a very light touch. You don't need a heavy touch with these at all. And once they dry, you can go back over them with the same color and get a little darker shade. And they don't take long to dry at all. At all. Okay, have I got all the flowers? Let's see. One, two, three, four. Okay, I got all the flowers. Let me zoom out. Oh, I remember when Jen did those pony beads. Oh, yes, I remember. She was in her kitchen. I do remember that. Yeah, I'd like to be there when she's baking some cookies too. Now I'm just tapping the pen onto the petal. I don't know, I think it gives it a little different. Oh, Jean, it was funny. It was fun too. Okay, so that's all with the blue. And is this my green? No, where's the green one? Here's my green. Now I need to get a brown, a light brown. Yeah. Ooh, that's not a light brown. That's an ugly brown. Well, for what I want to do, it's not pretty. Yes, I have these swatched, guys, but they are in another, that's in another book, and I don't want to take it out right now. Okay, so let me see. That's number 066. No, that's too dark. Okay, we're going to go with this. It's really beige. It's number 072 for the stem. I'm going to see how that looks. Oh, yeah, that looks good. So I'm coloring the stems. Oh, down here I made the stems green. Let's see. Well, you know, it'll be all right. So I'm gonna go over it one more time to make it a little darker. Okay. The blue looks it. This blue or the background blue? Oh, homemade peach ice cream. Oh, that sounds wonderful. Okay, so now I'm going to use the green and do the leaves. Thank you, Jen. I call the blue in the background, even though they say it's apple barrel China blue. It looks like robin's egg to me. This up here is still a little, I have to be careful up in here because this one, I can't drag it too long because it's still in some places a little damp. So I think I'll just tap it. I think it gives it a different type of texture when you do that versus brushing it. Is my head getting in your guys' way? My hair's a hot mess. I'm going to see my hairdresser Thursday. I'm going to crop on Friday and Saturday. It's both days. It's from 10 a.m. to 12 a.m. And yes, I can crop all that time. It's no problem for me. In fact, that's the way I like to crop, in a big spurt like that. And it's at the local scrapbook store where my friends is having a private crop. She's going to be doing it every month. So this will give me a good time to get, you know, for my our Alaska album when we went to Alaska. I've started it, and this will really, you know, help me to get it going. So I think, you know, you can, there's different ways you can do it. Like you can brush this, or like right now I'm tapping it and then I'm just getting rid of those little spots that it, you know, marks it makes. And I kind of think it gives it a really cool texture. I'll zero in a minute. Trying to figure out what, it's kind of hard sometimes on the stencils on wildflowers to figure out sometimes what exactly the leaf is. But you know what? I just paint it what I think it is, and then, because you know, it's my page, right? Okay. Oh, we're all going to go to Jen's house, and CB's going to charter the plane because she's going to win money. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to, let me look at this color again. I think I'll use this color. It's a light brown number 061. And I'll color these whatever they are in. And just give it a little more color. I think this will play good off of the gold in the cups. This was a flower that I missed, but don't tell anybody, it'll be our secret. Own it, Ella. Okay, Jen, I got it. I'm gonna own it because you told me I could. Okay, so I think that's everything. Oh no, I left something out up there. And I see another part of the, oops, wrong color. Hi, Iffy. Well, CB's gonna win some money, and then she's gonna charter a private jet, and she's gonna take us all down to Ozzie Grand's house, and she's gonna bake us some chocolate chip cookies or what, and peach ice cream, and maybe strawberry, and we're gonna art. I'm going over this one more time because I want it to be a little bit darker. Okay, and then in the middle there, I think I'm gonna put some yellow. This is number 050, yellow. Okay, so let's dry that. Make sure everything's dry because you know I'll stick my hand in it. Thank you. So I think I need to do something with these little butterflies right here. But I want to see if, just a second, guys. I want to see, this is my pit pen. This is, what color is this? Warm gray number two, warm gray 4273. Thanks, Iffy. I want to see if I can put some shadow under here. I've never used these before. I've watched other people use them, but maybe I need to put some gesso on the page before I use these. Or some, not gesso, some medium. What I want to do to this is I want to put some Wink Estella on there, on the flower part, so it will shine. This is the clear Wink Estella. You guys know I love my shimmer. I know. Well, see, I didn't put any gel medium on here, so I think that's why it's not rubbing as good. I mean, blending as well. So I'm going to stop and I'm going to put a little bit of gel medium there, and if it doesn't work, I'll just do what Jen did and cover it up. Where is the gel medium? You did great, Jean, on that face. You did really good. The shading and everything. And then I had to step away when you did the eyes. So I'm just putting some gel medium on this part of the page because I want to do some shading and my pit pen wasn't working too well for the shading because either I didn't know what I was doing or I forgot. I'm going to put some up here over the butterflies. Take this card. I'm just going to scrape that down real good. Okay. I thought you did really good, Jean. Really good. Okay. Okay, so now let's dry this. Bye, Linda. Still a little tacky right there. Okay, so I think it does go on smoother and it blends better. Like I say, I've never used these before, but I've seen other people use them. From giving shadows and stuff. And we all have to learn somewhere, huh? I think it looks pretty good for my first time. Thank you, Carol. Yeah, Jen, it's been doing that for about a month and a half now. For me, I haven't had any problem. About a month and a half going straight to YouTube. It was a pain while it wasn't working, to say the least. Thanks, Jean. Yeah, it's a Faber-Castell pit pen. It's warm gray 4273 asterisk asterisk asterisk. So I think I want to put some color in these butterflies. See. I'm gonna try the Zig 050, which is yellow, and see how that shows up. I think that looks pretty good. And the reason the butterflies aren't smearing is because I use the Stazon, which is a permanent ink. To upload to what, Jean? It took you that, you mean before they got the YouTube thing fixed? Right, that's what it takes mine too. Doesn't take very long at all to go directly to YouTube. Okay, so I want to write my quote down here before I put any more on the page. And I need to find something to write with. I can write with this Sharpie. Let me see. Where's my quote? My quote is, "Our friendship is like a cup of tea, a special blend of you and me." Our friendship. Okay. I don't know if I should use the fine point or the. I want to use the bullet. Just a second, guys. I'm gonna use a Sharpie and see what happens. Gonna use the fine one. And then if it needs to be thicker, I'll go over it. Oh, yeah, it's gonna need to be thicker. Our friendship was like a cup of tea, a special blend of you and me. So I'm going to try to be very careful and go over it again with this ultra fine point black Sharpie. And then I better heat set that because be my luck it smears. Okay, let me get a piece of I thought I had a piece of I used that. Okay, I'm gonna put this here so the sweat from my hands. Oh, you haven't seen the ultra fine? Yeah, I can't find my other one. It has the ultra fine on one end and the bullet on the other one. I have several of them. Now would be a good time because, you know, they got the back to school stuff up. Well, we didn't know you didn't have a Walmart down there. Good Lord, we thought they were everywhere. Do you have a dollar store or anything like that? Mid-year here, school shuts down for summer just before Christmas. So, Jen, but your kids, your schools have started back up now, right? Yeah, but $2 is good for this because they cost more than that. So your school year doesn't start till February, Jen? Because I thought you said your grandson was in school. Why do y'all start in February? I'm so confused. So let me put my initials here. Oh, your dollar stores have carp? So your kids only get a month off for school? I mean for some for from school? Well, I knew their seasons were backwards from us, rather. We're opposite of us. Correct? Is that right? When we're having summer, they're having winter. When we're having winter, they have summer. But I, oops. Oh, guys. Okay. But I thought you said your grandson that's living with you was starting back to school soon. Okay, so I want to. Where's my little birdie? I thought I saw him over here a minute ago. Oh, okay. All right. Sorry, I'm, I was just a tad confused there. So let me get my stamps back together before I leave something. Oh, he just had 2 weeks off. Okay. I know I saw the bird over here. Did y'all see where the bird went? Where the I don't think I crumbled him up in here. I hope not. Okay, hold on. Stop the bus. Gotta find the bird and the other little butterfly. Where's the block? Maybe that's where the bird, the butterfly is. Okay, I found the butterfly. All right, there's the butterfly. Now I gotta find the bird. Maybe he fell in here. Well, I'm very good at confusing my own self, so. Let me see if the bird fell in here. Oh, there he is. There's a little birdie. Okay, so I want to put this little birdie like right there. And again, I'm going to use my stays on. It's on my pin. Yeah, thanks, Sandra. Isn't it cute? I love him. I don't know, but two little birdies. Okay, and then he can go there. And then I'm gonna color those birdies in because they don't show up too well. Let me show you. So there's my quote. Our friendship is like a cup of tea, a special blend of you and me. And then I signed it over here. And I'm gonna color these little birdies. And I think I'm gonna color them blue. Another reason I love these Zig Clean Color markers is because the brush, it's a real brush tip, it's not a nib, and it's really fine, and you can get in the smallest little areas, and I like that. Yes, I did. 2016/08 for August. I did, Zandra, I did. These little birds are so cute. Oh, I'm sorry, Jen. What are you having to go through again? I missed it. Oh. Thank you, Terry. I'll back out in just a minute. I want to do something with those little birdies down there. I'm looking for one particular little color. Here it is. Is this it? No. Nope, that's not it. It's a baby blue. I think this is it. Haze blue. Yeah. Let me try this one. Okay. Oh, thank you, Terry. I like them too. Well, Jen, my mom raised my brother and I, and I'm 63, he's 61. Then he got married and had two kids, and she raised them, and they're now 32, 34 and 32. And then they got married, and she helped raise one of theirs, and he is now 12. And I have to say, they all turned out pretty good. Bumps and grinds in the road, but had our ups and downs, that's for sure. I know my mom has felt like tearing her hair out at times. Now I'm going to take this Micron 01, and this is, I don't know what color this is. It doesn't say what color it is. But it doesn't have a color on the, oh, that's the color on the cap. So I don't know what color you'd say that is. Yeah, my mom's 82 now. So I'm just going to trace around these little birdies with this pen. Well, my mother was raised by her grandmother, whom I never met. She died 3 years before I was born. And my mother will tell you to this day that she loved her mother, who is my grandmother, who I knew very well. She's also deceased. I need a darker pen than that. But if it had not been for my great grandmother, my mother said she don't know where she'd be. Well, I'm just going to keep getting this one. I'm too lazy to get up and get another one. My grandmother worked, and my great grandmother raised my mother and her siblings. And that's the one my mother called Mama. She's known from the South. And, I'm giving them some little antennas. So, God bless grandmothers. I think sometimes, well, I know a lot of times they're the backbone of our country as far as raising our children. I mean, it's sad in some cases, But I mean, that's your blood. That's how I kind of look at it. I mean, my mother certainly didn't think she'd be raising any more children after my brother and I. Yeah, I did. I did. I have a piece of paper over here. Thanks. Thanks, Lilith. I am originally from Charleston, South Carolina. I was born there. I lived on an island outside of the city called John's Island. There's a chain of islands together. There's James, John, Wadmalaw. And we lived on John's Island. And I stayed there except for the 2 years or so I went to college in North Carolina. And then I came back and then I met my husband. And we were married in 86. And he was stationed out in San Diego. So we got married and moved to San Diego. And the rest is history. Be 30 years December 27th. Yeah, when I would ride the bus, the first year I was in college, I went to University of North Carolina at Asheville. And the first year I was in college, I didn't have a car. So I'd come home on the Greyhound bus. So I get on the bus and I'm coming home and, you know, people are asking me, oh, where are you from? And I said, oh, I'm from Jones Island. Oh my gosh, do you have running water? And I said, no, we don't. Well, do you have to use the bathroom? I said, yes, we have outhouses. We have no indoor plumbing. I said, you know, it's really bad. And they were like, oh my gosh, you poor child. So after about 30 minutes, I told them, we have running water and electricity, and we don't have to use an outhouse. And you know, thanks, Jen. It just cracked me up that people thought, you know, just because you live on an island, you didn't have running water. And I mean, this was in the 1980s. Come on, people. You know, this wasn't in the back hills of, you know, Timbuktu. It was funny. I had a good time with it. So I'm using the Micron pen. It's 01. But it width, but it doesn't have a color on it. So all I can tell you is it's the color of this right here. I was very fresh, Bunny. What does that mean? What does that mean, Bunny? It was fun. I thought it was funny to tease them, you know. I thought, if you want to believe, it's brown. Okay, that's what I said too, Terry. If you want to believe, you know, that in the 1980s, in a populated place, yeah, I was snarky. I used to be very snarky. Very. But my husband took care of that. I think I'm gonna go around these branches here and give this some depth. My husband took a lot of that out of me because he didn't like it. He didn't like ladies who cursed because ladies didn't curse. So I figured, well, if I want him to like me, I better stop cursing. Oh yeah, I had a terrible mouth. Oh my God, it was terrible. I will tell you, it was terrible. Takes a lot to get me that way today, but it can happen. I mean, I'm not bragging, I'm just saying. It's still buried down there in my little toe. But my philosophy used to be, you don't like what I have to say, God gave you two legs and a neck. Take your legs and walk away and turn your neck, because you look a lot better going than you did coming. You couldn't stop what? Oh, swearing? Oh, yeah. Well, I used to be bad. I used to swear every other word. And he said, you know, I don't like that. Ladies don't curse. And you need to clean that mouth up. I was like, well, who the hell are you to tell me what to do? But then I really liked him, and I wanted to continue him to continue liking me and seeing me. So I said, okay. Yeah, way down in my toe. I don't like for it to come out. But you know, we all have that anger inside of us. And some of us just let it flow freely. And others of us, you know, we are able to control it until we need it. And when we need it, right? Yeah, I learned it. I learned it just enough to get the grade. Okay. Well, I'm not really sure what more I can do to this page. I like it. I think it turned out real pretty. I could probably go over this with a gold tip pen or something. But you know what? I like the way it looks. I'm really happy with it. I love the background. Well, yeah, I was 33 when I got married, Terry. You know, I was beginning to think I was never going to get married. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Jen, Bunny, Terry. I know, CB. I'm really happy with the background. I bought these bags of sponges from Hobby Lobby, and I got them in the art department. Let me see. I had the bag here that they came in. Oh, yeah. They're, I must not got them from Hobby Lobby because their sticker's not on here. They're plaid folk art 100% natural sea sponge value pack. So I either got them at, I didn't get them at Hobby Lobby because there's price stickers not on here, and there's stickers on everything. Yeah, they're sea sponges, Jen. So maybe I got them from Michael's. And they had this one. There's four of them in here. I don't remember them being very expensive. But I know they sell them. I know they sell these sponges in Hobby Lobby. And they might be a little pricier because I have seen them in the art section. But these, like I said, I didn't get these from Hobby Lobby. I don't remember. Yeah, they do last forever. But I knew I would like the texture. So these are the four. Like, look at this one. Here, let me put it on autofocus. Look at the texture on that one. Right? And then you have this one. I'm thinking I got them at Michael's. And then you have this one. And then the one I use today. And like I said, if I got them from Hobby Lobby, they'd have their sticker on them. You know how they have their sticker on everything. So I don't know where I got them from. So, does anybody have any questions for me? Anything they'd like to ask me or be nice and say to me? Yes, each side is different. That's what I like about them. Exactly. Exactly. So it was fun. I like the way it turned out. I'm real happy with it. Night, Sandra. So I'll see you guys. Let's see, tomorrow's Tuesday. I don't know who's streaming tomorrow. Oh, Cass. Cass 1415 usually streams tomorrow at 6:30 Eastern time. Okay, Terry. What's sad, Jean? What happened? What's sad? Thank you, Linda. Thank you, Terry. Hey, Jen, send me your if you haven't already, and if you have, send it again. Send me your mailing address. Sarah is supposed to stream tomorrow too. She streams 1:30 Pacific, 2:30, 4. Sarah streams at 4:30 Eastern time, 1:30 Pacific time. Oh, one of the hurdlers fell. Oh no. Okay, everybody. Well, have a great week. I'll see you tomorrow and on the other streams. You know, we'll catch up. Yes, Jen, you send me your mailing address. You might have before. If you did, I apologize for asking again. But look at the pretty sparkle on my flowers. Isn't it pretty? I love it. Yeah. Oh, they're asking if you're streaming tomorrow, Jen. Oh, Jen says she will be streaming Thursday night. And will you tweet it? Thanks, Grammy. Okay, guys. I'll see you later and have a good week and cheer for the Olympics of your country or whomever you want to cheer for. Okay, guys, bye.